Rahman say, Akhi, give my brother some water, man. Right? So, alhamdulillah, that is shafa'ah. He is interceding on behalf of his brother that I can give him some water. And this is what is called, what? That's al-urf, right? And it is the meaning of su'alul khayri lil ghayri. Su'alul khayri lil ghayri. Asking something good for someone else. Right? Interceding for someone else. So this is permissible to be done in this life. It is permissible in matters, barakallahu fikum, of the dunyawi matters. It is permissible for, barakallahu fikum, the brother, he want to study Arabic, and alhamdulillah, the teacher might not have time. Alhamdulillah, you come and say, Akhi, listen, barakallahu fikum, we need this. Can you help us? Alhamdulillah, okay, let's do it. Now, he asked something good for others. Tayyip. So, Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan, hafidhahullah, he say, وَكَذَلِكَ likewise. تطلب الشفاعة من الحي الحاضر بمعنى he say بمعنى أنه يطلب منه الدعاء he say that yes it could be sought from the one that is alive and he is present that the person بارك الله فيكم that can be he can ask الشفاعة from the one that is present and the one that is alive he can ask that. Just like he, barakallahu fikum, he asked, meaning the meaning of that is he's seeking dua. He is seeking for him to make dua. And we mentioned, barakallahu fikum, about the issue of me asking someone else to make dua for you. That it has to be first and foremost somebody that is known upon what? Upon tawheed. He's known upon tawheed. And he is also known upon what? Upon the sunnah, crystal clear sunnah. He's known upon tawheed. He's known upon the sunnah, barakallahu fiqh. You cannot be going to ask an individual that is a murid, right? Oh, I want you to make dua for me. Or a person that is a Naqshbandi, right? From the Turuq al-Sufiyya Naqshbandi, or the Shadhiliya, and the likes of this, oh, akhi, make dua for me, just because he got a big old turban. Right? Or he get a million mile dhikr bees with him. Right? So Shaykh Salih al-Fawdan hafidhahullah. He say like you will say, فَتَقُولُ like you will say, يَا فُلَان أُدْعُ اللَّهَ لِي بِكَذَا وَكَذَا. He say, oh, you like a person will say, oh, my brother, oh, so-and-so. Oh, so-and-so. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me about such and such. That is permissible. And as Shaykh Salih al-Uthaymeen mentioned, and all of this is to close the door of shirk. He said that your first intent is that you want to benefit your brother. That is supplicating for you. You want to benefit him to be closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. To be closer to Allah. To be closer to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Because without the doubt, that the dua is what? Is the greatest act of worship. The greatest act of worship is what? A-du'a. The greatest act of worship is a-du'a. So you ask your brother to make dua for you because you want to benefit him. You want him to increase in being, yani having nearness with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He say, تقول فتقول that you will say, يا فلان so and so. Like the person will say, oh so and so. ادعو الله لي بكذا وكذا. And he ask Allah تبارك وتعالى for me on my behalf about such and such. He say, كما طلب عمر as عمر رضي الله عنه sought الدعاء من العباس as عمر رضي الله عنه sought the دعاء from Al-Abbas. From Al-Abbas. What was the dua that Umar sought from Abbas? What did Umar ask Al-Abbas to ask? Hassan? No, I didn't say that. I like that answer too. What did Umar ask Al-Abbas to ask? Abdul Rahman. To seek the rain. How you say that in Arabic? Al tis ahsanta. Al is tis qa. For those who are a little older than him, if you didn't know it, write it down. Al istisqa, seeking the rain. The dua for seeking the rain. Al istisqa, seeking the rain.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Go bring me the stick. Turn around the other way. Right there. Stay right there. حول عقادة حول عقادة إلا بالله حول عقادة إلا بالله حول عقادة إلا بالله. Just for you, for nobody else.
Yeah. Naam, so he mentioned, as Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, as Umar radiyallahu anhu sought al-istisqa from Al-Abbas radiyallahu anhum ajma'in. And he said, wa kama yatlubu an-nas, as also the people they will be seeking yawm al-qiyamati, on the day of judgment, الشفاعه من الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في المحشر, as the people also will be seeking the intercession from the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم في المحشر, meaning in that gathering place, in that gathering place. So this, alhamdulillah, was in regard to the shubha number 4. So we are, alhamdulillah, heading to the shubha al-khamisa, right, the fifth doubt that the people of Qubur, the Quburiyin, they are bringing about, to what? To want to justify that it is permissible that you place between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala someone. So what is that shubha? That shubha is very, and it's simple, and it is, innal mushrikeen al-awwalin, that the first generation of the polytheists, يَدْعُونَ الْأَصْنَامَ, that they used to call on the asnam. They used to call on the asnam. They used to call on the asnam. طيب, my question is, the word al-asnam, does it also carry the word of awthan? There's the word here. He said that the first generation of the mushriks, They used to call on the asnam, right? Now, does it mean also that they used to call on the awthan? Is it the same meaning? Naam? Huh? No. Huh? Same? The question is that the mushrikeen, the sheikh, he say, that the mushrikeen of the first generation, right? يَدُعُونَ الْأَصْنَامِ, they used to call on the asnam, the word asnam. You have another word that is al-awthan, right? Now my question, is it possible to interchange these two words in here, Abu Munir? Huh? Huh? La. I like to hear la loud and clear. Yes. Could it be interchanged? Leave him alone. Leave him alone. Go ahead, son. Can we interchange these two words in here in this sentence? He said la. Yes or no?
Yes or no? Can these two words be interchanged in here? You say yes? Abishir.
No.
Na'am. I don't know. Don't raise your hand. No. Abdurrahman? La Adri. Muhammad? Abu Bakr? Can they be interchanged in here? Na'am. Limada? Sahih. Here it is because of the simple fact that if one is mentioned, the other one is also be carried out. If they are both mentioned, then now the asnam and the awthan will be two different things. But if one is mentioned, it carries out the meaning of the other one. Because the asnam are those form, right? Those idols that they made in a human form or in something that have a ruh form. Something that has a ruh, right? They build their gods on something that has a ruh, right? Whether it is a sculpture of a bird or Buddha or whatever is something that has a soul. But amma da awthan, it is not something that has a soul. It could be a tree. It could be something that is a rock. It could be something that is barakallahu feekum, huh? It could be something that doesn't have no soul. So therefore here, that the first generation of the mushrikeen, yadu'una al-asnam, also it means yadu'una al-awthan. Right? If they are mentioned together, ikhtalafha. If they are mentioned separately, ijtama'ata, they are together. Fahimtu. It's just the word al-rabb wal-ilah. It's just the word al-rasul wal-nabi, right? If they are mentioned together, they are all separate. If they are mentioned separately, that everyone will take the meaning of the other one, kathalika. Tayyip. So here this shubha, barakallahu feekum, it is. Now that they used to call on the asnam, and they used to call on the shayateen, and they used to call on the jinn. Amma nahnu, as us today, فَنَدُعُوا أُنَاسًا, we are only calling human beings. So they say the first mushrikeen, now hear this out. This could make sense for someone that does not have no aqidah upbringing. Look, the first generation, they used to call on the idols. They used to call on shaitan. They used to call on the jinns. As of us today, amma nahnu, as us today, فَنَدُعُوا أُنَاسًا, we are calling human beings صالحين, that are righteous. We are calling on righteous people. We are not calling on no rock. We are not calling on no statue. We are not calling on no tree. We are not calling on no shaitan. We are not calling on no jinn. We are only calling on righteous people. We are only calling on Abdul Qadir al-Jailani. We are only calling on al-Badawi. We are only calling in help me with some names. Ahmad Bamba. We are only calling on al-Tijani. We are not calling on the jinn. We are not calling on the shaitan. We calling on righteous people. So therefore they will say, فَكَيْفَ تَجْعَلُونَ, how is it that you are making الصالحين كالأصنام? How in the world you wanna compare the idols to the righteous people? How you wanna put them all in the same bag? How dare are you to be comparing the asnam, the idols, to these righteous people? The first generation, they used to call on the idols. They used to call on the shaitan. They used to call on the jinn. But as us today, we are calling on the righteous people. How dare are you to make a comparison between these two? Will it make sense? Right? It will make sense for somebody that doesn't have no tarbiyatul islamiyya.
Somebody doesn't have no Islam.